Hello friends, now we will talk about or discuss the different capacitances of MOSFET. MOSFET has got the dielectric layer, it has got the different junctions, so because of which it will be offering the capacitance which will be playing very important role at high frequencies. So before we study the high frequency response of MOSFET, we need to see what are the different capacitances in MOSFET. Fine. So very first point you should remember is we have an oxide between the gate electrode. This is gate electrode and the body. Body is this substrate. Fine. This is this region between, this is called source region, this is called drain region. So this is the layer which is drain. If you talk about N channel, so it will be N channel MOSFET. Fine. So this region between the drain and source layers is called channel. Fine. So we have got oxide layer between gate electrode and channel. So it offers some capacitance, and that capacitance per unit area of oxide layer for this length L, channel length L, is given by epsilon naught OX by T naught X, where T naught X is the thickness of this layer and epsilon naught X is nothing but dielectric constant of this oxide layer. Fine. This is capacitance per unit area, and if you take absolute capacitance, you need to multiply it WM and L. That becomes the area, total area of contact between the oxide and channel, oxide layer and channel, or you can say this gate and oxide. Fine. So I'll not talk about this. So this W into L, W is width of the channel, overall width of the channel, and L is length of the channel. So area of contact between the oxide and channel is nothing but W into L. So if you multiply this oxide layer capacitance per unit area by W into L, so that becomes total capacitance in farad. Now come back to the different capacitances. MOSFET has got four terminals. This is source terminal, drain terminal, gate terminal, and this is body terminal. In normal case, the body terminal is connected with source. Fine. It is normally connected with source, but here we will be talking about these terminals separately to study the capacity effect. The gate has got dielectric layer, so it will be offering some capacity effect. So we will see the different capacitances because of this oxide layer between gate and channel. So first I'll be saying, the point you should remember is the MOSFET terminals, different terminals of MOSFET are held at different potential, and whenever there is different potential between two points, there will be capacity effect. So the capacitances due to the gate capacity effect will be gate to source capacitance, gate to drain capacitance, gate to body capacitance. So these three, gate to source capacitance, gate to source means between these two points, then gate to drain, between gate and drain, then gate to body, between gate and body, and last one, there is one more capacitance which is gate overlap capacitance. What is the meaning? There is overlap of gate electrode and source region, this small region, this small part, this area of overlap will be giving me a capacitance which is nothing but gate overlap capacitance. Similarly, there is area of overlap between this gate and drain region, so that is overlap. So since it is symmetrical, so I will be assuming area of overlap between gate and drain and gate and source is same. Fine. So these are the four capacitances we will be talking about. So these capacitances basically should be added to gate to drain and gate to source itself. So this gate to source should be capacitance due to overlap should be added to gate to source, and this capacitance due to overlap should be added to gate to drain. Fine. Then let us talk about junction capacitance. So here we have junction between source and body, so it will be offering me a capacitance. We have junction between drain and body, it will be offering me a capacitance. So source to body capacitance and drain to body, these are junction capacitances. Fine. So let us see the first one, first part. When we have different modes of operation of MOSFET, that is ohmic, saturation and cutoff. So there are different potentials. There are different potentials at gate, source and drain terminal for ohmic region, for saturation region and cutoff region. Accordingly, the capacitances will be different. So first, I will be talking about this, and let us talk about ohmic region. For ohmic region of operation, the gate to source capacitance is same as gate to drain, and that is half of C naught X multiplied by W into L. Now remember, this is capacitance per unit farad, sorry, per unit area. I can say it is the capacitance measured in farad per meter square. If you multiply it by area, so this capacitance becomes capacitance in farads. Maybe microfarad, maybe millifarad, maybe picofarad, and so on. So that is why we are multiplying this capacitance, which was capacitance per unit area of the oxide layer, into WL. Fine. And B, for saturation region, why is it so? In the first case, why is it so? Because for ohmic region, drain to source voltage is very small and channel is almost uniform. There is channel below the gate electrode and that is almost uniform. So for uniform channel, we divide, take half of for each, you know, terminal. Then for saturation region, CGS, for saturation region, channel becomes narrow towards gate. So narrow towards drain, it is like this at the beginning. So when channel is narrow, in that case, the gate to source capacitance becomes 2 by 3 of CW, C naught X into WL, and CGD become 0. Remember this. And third one, for cutoff region, there is no channel here. The capacitance CGS is equal to CGD, and that is 0. But gate to body capacitance is C naught X W into L. Remember this. Gate to body capacitance for cutoff region is simply this capacitance multiplied by area of overlap between the oxide and channel. That's it. Fine. So these are the different capacitances for, you know, that is for different regions. But let us talk about overlap capacitance. So for overlap capacitance, everything will be similar. The overlap capacitance C naught V, that will be same for source and drain. Assuming that this is symmetrical, your device is symmetrical, so overlap area for source is same as overlap area for drain, and that is given by C naught X into W into L area of, that is length of overlap. What is length of overlap? This was the channel length for previous case. In this case, I am talking about the capacitance offered by overlap area, and say that length of overlap is LOV. So COV, that is capacitance due to overlap, will be C naught X into W into LOV, where L is length of overlap. So that should be added to gate to source as well as gate to drain. Fine. That is capacitance due to overlap, or you can say overlap capacitance. So you should remember these expressions. These are important. Maybe there can be question in gate exam. Then let us talk about the junction capacitances. Fine. Second one, junction capacitances. And there are, I repeat, there are two junctions. First is junction between source and body. Second is junction between drain and body. If junction capacitance for source, that is CSB, will be equal to epsilon naught of the semiconductor, area of overlap between source and body divided by width of the depletion layer between source and body. You please see, there is formation of junction between source and the body, means substrate, and this is forming a depletion layer throughout the area of contact between source and board. If there is depletion layer formation, let width of the depletion layer of this junction is WSB, that is width of the depletion layer between source and body, and let ASB is area of contact between source and body. This complete area of contact between source and body is nothing but ASB. Then the capacitance between source and body is given by this. This is essentially junction capacitance, and width of the depletion layer between source and body is given by 2 epsilon by Q. Epsilon is the dielectric constant of this semiconductor. Fine. That is semiconductor of the MOSFET, maybe silicon. Fine. So this is 2 epsilon by Q into 1 by acceptor concentration, 1 by donor concentration. Remember, for n-channel MOSFET, the substrate is always p-type. So this will be into V naught plus VSB. What is this? That is voltage between source and base terminal. That is the reverse biasing voltage between source and base terminal under root. V naught is called built-in potential. I repeat, V naught is called built-in potential of the source body junction. VSB is reverse biasing voltage between source and base terminal, not base, source and body terminal. And A is acceptor concentration in P substrate, and A is donor concentration in source region. Epsilon is the dielectric constant of the semiconductor of the MOSFET. Q is the charge of electron. Fine. Similarly, we have the junction between drain and body, so it will be offering a capacitance, and that capacitance will be, that is, drain and body. Capacitance between drain and body. So here it will be area ADB will be area of contact between drain and body. So area of contact between drain and body will be this complete area. WDB will be width of the depletion layer between drain and body. This depletion layer width, that is WDB. This width will be WDB. Fine. So in that case, the width of the depletion layer between drain and body will be similar to previous one. It will be simply changing, that is, built V naught will be built-in potential at this junction, and VDB will be reverse biasing voltage between drain terminal and body terminal. That's it. So this is the expression of junction capacitance for drain and body junction. So these are the different capacitances which are existing in MOSFET, but all of these capacitances are not used for study of high frequency response. For study of high frequency response, only these two will be studied. These two will be used, I will say, for study of high frequency response of BJT. Fine, that is gate to source and gate to drain. So in next video, I'll be talking about the high frequency model of BJT. So just wait for my next video. Thank you very much for watching the video.